Hi everyone, this is Dave. Now you all know I absolutely love my timepieces, and Spinnaker Watches very kindly sent me this very special dive watch. Let's take a look inside the box. So here we go. This is what the Spinnaker product packaging looks like. We've got this nice outer box. This particular timepiece is the Spinnaker Cahill Vintage Diver, reference SP5033-01. Now inside this outer box, we've got a really nice wooden box as well. Let's just remove this. We can take a closer look. This is just beautifully presented. And this is a vintage diver. So you're getting something very, very special here. Inside, we've got the little tag with the reference number on. So if you want to check this out for yourself, this is what you're looking for. We've also got the watch itself, of course. It's presented on this leather strap. But inside, we've also got a grey NATO strap as well. And this looks absolutely fantastic on the watch. I have tried it on there and it looks absolutely superb. It's a very high quality NATO strap as well. Now, we get a watch strap removal tool and just overall very nice presentation. But let's take a look at the star of the show, which of course is the Spinnaker Cahill. Now this has got a Japanese movement in here. I think it's a Miyota movement. It's 42 millimeters in size and 20 meters water resistance. And it's just so nicely done. Very, very nice. This is one of the best Spinnaker timepieces I've actually experienced. It just looks so luxurious. So let's take a look at the side profile. It's quite a thick watch, but it is very, very well finished and very lightweight. We've got sort of brushed finish into the majority of the case, but we have got some polished elements on the bevels on the lugs here, for example. So nice attention to detail. You can also see here that Spinnaker is engraved on the side. If we move round to the crown, we've got a signed crown. This is a screw down crown as well. So let's unscrew this. And when it pops out to position one, we can actually hand wind the watch, and it's very, very smooth indeed. And if we pop it out to position number two, we can actually do the quick date change feature. So we've got that date window at 3 o'clock. Nice that this is white on black as well. So it's just really beautifully done. And then if we pull this out to the last position, we can adjust the time. Now you'll see it doesn't have hacking seconds, but when you move the hands backwards, you can stop that seconds hand from moving. So you can get quite an accurate time setting. And then when you've done with finishing the setting of the time and the date, we can pop this back in and thread this crown back on and screw it back down. And when it's in its screwed down position, we've got that 200 meters of water resistance. Now the bezel here as well, really nicely done, and it is unidirectional, so it doesn't move in this direction. There's a little tiny bit of play in it, but a nice, firm and precise movement to the bezel. And then when we get round to the 12 o'clock mark, everything lines up nicely at the 12 o'clock mark. A really nice distressed vintage looking leather strap, nice and thick as well, very thick gauge. And we've got these little pieces of material here and the contrasting stitching on the tip. And we've also got the really nice large buckle that's also signed with the Spinnaker branding as well. We take a look around at the watch back. We've got an exhibition case back on here as well. So you can see the rotor moving around in that nice blue color, again, signed with the Spinnaker branding. And you can see that Japanese movement ticking away inside very, very nicely. It's not overly decorated, but at least it has got some decoration. It's really nice. I do like timepieces where you can see that movement inside. Now on the wrist, it wears very, very nicely indeed. It is quite a thick watch though, so you're not going to get away with wearing this with shirt cuffs because they don't go over the watch very, very easily. This is more of a sport watch, something you're going to wear in a casual situation, jeans and a t-shirt, jeans and a jumper, and it just looks absolutely stunning. If you take a closer look at the actual dial design, you can see we've got some sort of a texture to that black dial as well. So it's not glossy, it's not matte, it's sort of somewhere in between. So it's got a nice grain to it. We've got applied indices with plenty of lume on here as well. It looks absolutely stunning, very nicely balanced as well, and just beautifully done. And for the price point, it really does give you a lot of quality and a lot of value for money. This is the Spinnaker Cahill. I'll leave a link to the Spinnaker website in the video description. If you enjoyed this video, as always, please do hit that like button. Please do subscribe, and I'll see you in another video very soon.